Hello, and welcome back to DevNull Gaming. So, during the between episodes, I've worked a little bit on trying to expand out, get some food, start planning out for some energy sources, gathered a lot of cobble. I mean, heck, I've filled up this entire double chest and the hopper that's connected to it. I've broken a lot of cobble down into gravel, sand, dust, etc. Got a few bar iron ingots, a little bit of redstone, some yellowium, just a little bit of everything going. Started working on some plants, made one of these neat small storage crates, and started filling it with all my plants and harvested goods and all that type of stuff. So, yeah. I figured, hey, you know, I've actually got a pretty decent idea of what I'm about to do, so I'd like to go ahead and get another quick recording session going. That way, I can actually execute without, you know, you guys coming back and saying, hey, how'd you do this? You did so much without us. You know, I gotta be nice to you guys, because y'all are awesome. So, let's see here. I was looking at the app. Actually, and then inside of here there was a generator or something like that. There was something in here that I was looking to make. I think it's the... Well, I know I wouldn't mind doing a coal generator, just because it's extra power. Let's see here. I know I want to get an oil generator made, but the problem is I need this black quartz. And in order to get that, I need nether quartz, which, in order to get that, we have to get soul sand, which also has to go through a flint mesh. So, we still got a little bit to do here. Well, a lot of bit. So, let me think here. So, we need to have something that can store up some energy. Some energy. How about we look at this at immersive engineering. Okay, and we'll go ahead and get started in here, or see if we can, because we need blast bricks, which needs blaze powder and bricks. So let me think here. I need clay for that. To make clay, I can use dust inside of a barrel. And I do happen to have two bits of water over here that I gathered up. And since I threw away all the buckets that I had cheated in, you know, like I should have, let me go ahead and make a bucket. Wait. Weird. Okay, so apparently you can set those on the ground. That's pretty cool, but it was unexpected. Okay, so, oh, those are in my inventory. Derp. Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and pour that out there. And we're going to go downwards just a touch. And get back up. There we go. Alright. So, we'll go ahead and just make a nice little pool here. Okay, so we've got a little bit there, a little bit there, a little there, a little there, and we'll go ahead and shift it so I can get out here. Let's see here. I probably could have done this a little bit more effectively, but hey, it's my talent. My talent is being able to do things in a highly ineffective manner. So, we will continue to do it in an ineffective manner. Because that's how we do things around here. Piss poll. Nah, I'm actually... Well, I'm not gonna say I'm great or anything, because I know I'm certainly not. But I'm not horrible. There's definitely people who are better than me at this. And that... I don't think anyone's going to try and argue that. But I at least do somewhat okay. Oh. Forgot I have to do this on the lower level. And I somehow accidentally killed my second water source. Awesome! You know what I was saying about not being that bad? Well, I think I actually am. Ah, sheesh. How did I manage to mess that up? Well, now I just gotta wait for it to rain. Which, on the bright side, I haven't made a bed or anything, although I should. So, it should rain any day now. We'll go ahead and make a bed. There we go. We get some wool. Then we get some of these planks. There we go. We got a bed. So that's something. I really wasn't quite expecting to screw up like that. Because that's special even for me. Oh well. We just gotta press forward and keep doing what we're doing, you know? So, let me think here. How do we get water in there without rain? So I was thinking there was a way, but I can't remember it. So, how do we get water? Ooh, so certain fruits provide water in a wooden crucible. So, with that in mind, I bet watermelons would actually do pretty well. Let's see here. So, leaves do well. Okay, let's go ahead and make one of these crucibles. Because, yeah. I goofed. So, we are looking for a crucible, which is 6 wood and 1 slab. Don't tell me I'm out of regular wood. Well, I am actually out of regular wood. I don't need anyone to not tell me that. I can just straight see because, well, I see it. So, actually this won't grow here because it's got that big tree on it. So we're gonna have to cut down this apple tree. I mean, this will at least give me enough wood to do what I need, I think. Because I should be able to use this wood, right? Nope. So I actually will need to cut down at least one or two trees. Or one or two more to actually make this crucible. On the bright side, it'll be awesome whenever it gets grown. On the drawback, I kind of had to cut down a fruit tree. And this thing cost me 3 apples to make. I'm pretty sure it's not going to drop apple saplings. Nope. Drop standard oak. Okay, so twerk by it while watering it. This tree is just like, oh my lord! Okay. So now this should be enough material to do what I need. Or at least I sure hope it is. Because it'll stink if it isn't. Okay, so shears. I see, so they took away the ability to do wooden shears. And cobblestone shears. Well, that stinks. So it looks like it has to be out of these weird stone thingies from here. So I do have two of this that I can spare. Come on. There we go. Okay. So we'll go ahead and just trim down these leaves. There we go. Okay. So now we've got an oak crucible. We'll go ahead and just drop that here. Then I should be able to do... Yeah. There we go. So this is giving us a water supply. So I have 27 uses on this hammer, so let's go ahead and do 6 dust. Oh, wait, I have one less. I think I should still have enough, though. So we'll go ahead and see if my quick in my head math was enough, and yeah, I had more than enough. Good. Whew. I would have been a little bit disappointed if I didn't have enough from that. Because I would have been like, really? Really, I can't even do basic math in my head. And if I can't trust myself to do basic math in my head, who can I trust to do basic math in my head? And the little voice in my head tells me he's always right. I have to believe him. I'm kidding. I don't have a little voice in my head. Though that would be pretty funny. Oh yeah, and on here I added make a house. So that's kind of something I was thinking about was, hey, it might not be a bad idea to start looking at making a home. That way I can, you know, start progressing towards getting a place to sleep that's not in the rain. Because, you know, rain stinks, at least when you're trying to sleep in it. Anyone who's gone camping would know it's kind of difficult to sleep in the rain if you don't have any tent or at least decent shelter. I mean, even a tree is good enough, but you need something. Okay. So, we are almost there, and bam! We have an endless pool of water. Okay, so we put those in there. And now we get clay. Sweet. And these are big blocks of clay, too. So that means we can actually get a lot of little clay from this. So, let's go ahead and just break all this up. Oh, look at all the clay. Okay. This is driving me crazy. Okay, so we go back to immersive engineering. We need blast bricks, and we need coke bricks. So, all of these need lots of bricks. So, this needs to be a 3x3 structure. So, that would be 9... 9, That's 18, then another 9, so that's 27. Okay, so I need 8 clay per 2. Da 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 da, half of 27, that means I need at least 10, that would give me 20. Another 5 would give me 30. So that's too much. So 10 is 20. To heck with it. We just need a bunch more clay. So let me go ahead and grab out some more cobble. And then we need some sticks. Okay. Cool. So we now have hammers. Let's go ahead and do one stack of cobble. So that'll give us 4 stacks of clay. That means we need to do 2 stacks of bricks and 2 stacks of clay balls. I think that'll be enough to get us a blast furnace and a coke oven. What this also means is we're going to need a factory. Because I don't really like the idea of having things like a coke oven just sitting out in the open. I mean, some people might be okay with that. That's not how we do things here at DevNull Gaming. Next episode, you will probably see it sitting out in the open. Because, well, I just said that's how we do things, and as you guys have seen, I'm totally good at keeping my word when it comes to saying, yeah, I'm not gonna cheat. Well, let me just spawn in a little bucket of water here, a little bucket of lava there. Spawn, 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 cheat, 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 cheat. I don't wanna do that. I hate cheating, and I hate going back on my word. So, I definitely do want to build a nice factory floor, especially for all the immersive engineering stuff. So, the goal is we're going to try and make some sort of a factory or of at least a building of sorts for all of the immersive engineering. That's what I want to do with this, because I think, A, it would look nice. I'd like to try and keep each mod pack, like, in its own area. Because I think that would be pretty cool, actually, to say, hey, in this wing of the sky block, we have immersive engineering. In this wing, we have agriculture. In this wing, we have our dimensional teleportation systems. But we want to actually do this where it's not going to, A, look like a big sack of butt, or a big sack of ass. Yeah, I try not to use too much language on here simply because, A, I mean, it's unnecessary. Foul language is just completely unnecessary. If you want to use it, go for it. I will say that if you use it too much, then it completely loses its punch. Because if you go around dropping F-bombs every other word, then when you actually need the extra oomph or the extra emphasis that dropping one would give, then everyone around you like, oh yeah, you say that every third word, Billy. That you're just saying it again anyway, who cares? But if everyone around you knows, oh well, this guy, he never curses, never swears, never hear anything dirty come out of his mouth. If he all of a sudden says, drops an F-bomb in a conversation, then everyone around is gonna be like, whoa, we did something wrong. At least that's the general idea that I have when I think about it. Because I'm like, you know, it's unnecessary. Sure, it is fun sometimes. But It's just unnecessary, and it loses its meaning and punch if you use it all the time. And secondly, I know that younger audiences may actually watch my videos at some point, or they may overhear what I'm saying in just normal conversations. I really don't want to be a contributor to children using foul language. I know that's kind of silly considering kids that are like in elementary school curse and they use some pretty nasty language. But, you know, we can't just accept that as the status quo. If you don't like the way something's going, do your part to try and make a difference. That's what matters in the end. Is that you do your part, and in the end, you aren't contributing to the negatives. Because that's how we move forward as a people. That's how we move forward as a society. By actually just working together to try and help each other, try and not degrade each other. At least any more than people already will naturally. Because some people don't exactly need help with degrading themselves. I mean, look at me. I'm proving very quickly just how inept I am at video games, and this is one of my favorite things to do. And I'm just like, well, yeah, I'm very, very readily showing the world just how bad I am. And that's not bad good, that's bad bad. So, yeah, it's one of those, just be who you are, and you'll have fun. At least that's my mentality. It's worked okay for me in the past, like, almost 25 years that I've been trying that now. So, yeah. Not bad. Admittedly, I could probably be in better places or better job or something like that if I had conformed to the world around me. If I had actually just been like, yeah, you know, I'm okay with not being who I am, with being who the world tells me I should be. You know, some people are really okay with that. So, if you're one of those people, hey, more power to you. There's nothing wrong with that. If it works for you, it works for you. Because eventually, you'll be that person. And it won't be you're trying to play someone else's role. You'll just be who you are. You be you. Okay. I'm done with that rant. I apologize for going on a little long with it. But hey, I had a good rant, I got a lot off my chest, etc., etc. And it gave me a few moments to actually think. All I'm really hoping is that I'm not doing anything too stupid with this. I do know with these weird, like, menthol trees, or... Sorry. With these mineral trees, I probably need to spread them out a little further if I actually want to keep planting them. Because they don't seem to be quite so friendly with the two space between each. They look like they probably need about 3 to 5 space between... I mean, I can work with that. I can work with that. So, let's see here. Looks like the canola seeds are growing well. Let's go ahead and throw some clay in here. And we'll grab some coal out for it, just because we kind of need to have more available. Sweet. Okay. Go ahead and pick off a few apples. There we go. And while I'm waiting on that, I may as well go ahead and water the canola. There we go, we get some extra canola. And we'll eventually make an oil presser so I can get the canola oil, and we can make a oil generator so we can have a very renewable source of energy. And that'll be just wonderful. Let's see here. We are looking to make coke. So I need sandstone. Wait, where'd it go? There it is. Okay, so I need sandstone, which is 4 sand. So for that, I'm going to need more and more. We'll do half a stack. Okay. Okay, and we're going up. We're going up all the way. Yeah, that was kind of a lame joke. Or a lame song. Or at least I sang it lame. There we go. Let's see here. Oh yeah, this actually won't be... Well, no, this might be enough. We'll find out. We'll definitely find out here shortly if this is enough sand to break down. So, let's see here. We got some gravel. Gonna put down the gravel, then we're gonna hammer this down, then we'll get sand, so we'll have 32 sand. That'll give us roughly 12 sandstone? No, we'll have less than that. We'll have like 8. Which definitely won't be enough to make all of the coke brick. Let me grab some food. Starving stinks. Okay, there we go. I'm putting food in. Okay, so full belly. Okay, so it's only 8 that we get here. So that stinks. But we get at least a few things done. So, let's see here. I believe it's something like that and that. Okay, so I got these backwards. Okay, so that gives us 10 coke brick. Nope, we're not putting this down yet. That's going in a factory. It's going to go in a factory. So, I definitely know what I'm going to be building it out of. Though, if I'm going to do that, I think I'm going to look into a chisel so I can chisel the cobblestone so it doesn't look quite so trashy. Because regular cobble just looks like garbage. It really does. It looks so bad. But, with it, at least if they haven't changed the recipe, I should be able to do this and get a chisel. And then with this, I should be able to come over here, grab out a stack of cobble, plop that in there, and we can make, yeah, nice. We can get bricks, we can get all sorts of neat little patterns. I think we're going to go for a large brick for the exterior wall. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. So, we're going to go ahead and actually start building out towards the factory right now. So, we're going to start here on this corner. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. A very important skill that everyone should know if they want to be an awesome gamer like me. Learn to count. Counting is important. A really good step, if you actually want to be great, is be able to remember what you actually said when you counted. That's usually my difficulty, is I end up forgetting exactly how far I go, or how many I went out. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and make the floor of the factory. So the floor, I want the floor to be made in, let's go with these zag patterns. Up, not slanted, we want zag and zag. Okay. Looks like the number of uses on the chisels went way down. And that's not a problem, it's just a little bummer. Okay, so factory floor. We're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21, and 22. That'll give us an internal space of 20. Okay. So now that we've got that worked out, we need to figure out the width. So let's go... Let's go 10 in each direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. And we'll go ahead and go out this way a bit. So we go out to meet the other one, which I'm not counting. And there we go. Awesome. Okay. So we've got the base direction that way. There we go. That's met up now. Okay, so now we'll go out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then we just go straight out. Now we're still in a forest biome, so that's pretty nice. And this zag pattern actually looks really decent. Okay. So we've got all these edges lit up. So now the main task will be connecting up all the floors, then putting up all the walls, then putting up an exterior perimeter around all of this so we can actually have some usable walking space. But all in all, I think I can work with this. Yeah. Yeah, I can totes work with this. We'll have the door here. That'll enter into the factory floor, where we then have all this exterior. Wait, I still have more zag tiles. Sweet. Let's make the first floor. Let's have it have a ceiling that's 10 high. I think that should be a decent height.
No.
I swear. I haven't been blinking. Swazzies. If I actually sounded like a decent drunk, then I don't think people would believe me still. Okay, so we need blaze powder here. Wait, so what's this one need then? I thought blast brick. Oh, it's poop. It's nether bricks. So this takes a lot of redstone. Man. Okay. Dang. That's gonna take a lot of work to get that. Let me think here. I know I don't have to have blast brick right away. But the thing is, I will have to have steel. I mean, there's just no way around that. Although a lot of the recipes that need steel can also work with iron. So we may be able to get away with some of this, but not a lot. So let's see here. It's like even the water wheel takes a steel ingot. Now, if I could do these steel essences, that'd be pretty sweet. But in order to get those essences, I'm going to need a monster spawning area. So, let's go ahead and make one of those. I didn't want to put you down. Okay, so let's go ahead and make a door. Okay, we'll go ahead and throw this junk in here. And let's go ahead and make the monster area back here. I actually do want to put these coke bricks away before I accidentally place them. Okay. Do this. A decent distance away. So we're just going to go for a little bit. So this is about 20 bricks. Okay, so we're 24 out. Just make this a nice little three wide road. So, yeah, we're going to just make this nice and three wide. And I need to put another piece of cobble there. There we go. Now we get to the building itself. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's go 7. Yeah. And then we go over here. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, sure. So we'll go ahead and just make this into this weird shaped building. Let's see here. To do one more? Yeah, one more. Yeah. Okay. And we want to make this at least 5 blocks tall. That way we have space even for Endermen to spawn in there. That'll be a decent idea. Let's spawn horrible enemies that can warp around outside of the room where they're supposed to stay and can kill us. Sounds like a wonderful plan to me. Although, it may end up going better than I hope. Maybe it'll be a Linderman. You know, one of the Endermen that actually likes giving you things, but expects them back later. Okay. Da-da-da-da. We are building. So, I'm hoping that I can get some loot bags from this. Because loot bags give you a chance to get the base essences, which you can use to make the essence crops, which you can use to get more essence, and then you can use that to get things like iron, steel, copper, gold. Just grow it. Because, you know, it's natural. So, okay. Let's go ahead and hammer off these little eyesore tumor spots. There we go. We'll go ahead and ditch that hammer. Let's go grab some more cobble out of the box. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, blah, blah, blah. Okay. So we're full on cobble. And the door is pretty much just going to be sitting right in the middle. Nothing overly special. So, when we come back for next episode, I will have this monster room finished, and I should have the factory floor at least made into a floor. So, I'd like to thank all of you lovely people for taking time to watch again, and take care, and stay awesome. Bye!